Good morning. I just woke up. I feel like filming a video. I'm going to start with my makeup because I haven't worn makeup in a little while actually. And whenever I have a fake tan, I feel like it's a wasted opportunity not to wear makeup because makeup looks so much better when you have, I don't know why, it's like fair skin just shows up all of the mistakes and redness shows through and it comes off more easily and it's more inclined to be patchy and all that fun stuff. So, how's life, everyone? How is life? It is a Monday morning. What is the time? 8:27. I've got an Apple Watch and it says mindfulness. You did one mindfulness session this past week. One singular. The last one I had was from 2016, I think. So this is the SE 44mm, which is really big for my wrist, but I like it. It's encouraged me to go for walks every day, to actually be active, which I've been really struggling with. I mean, I go to Pilates every 3 times a week, but I was fitter when I lived in Perth because I had a personal trainer that was pushing me really hard to do a lot of weight training and cardio, which built muscle, which is good for my metabolism. But down here I've been I haven't been pushing myself with Pilates. Like, I've been using it more as like a lengthening, stretching, toning, but I've said to my instructor, like, can we do more cardio based stuff, which does all of that, but also it gets my heart rate up so that I'm feeling like fit again. Because at first I was like, it's fine, who cares? But now I realize, no, actually it does, it impacts my mental health when I'm not at a point where I know I can be, if that makes sense. Sorry about my deep, creaky voice. As I said, it's the morning. So I was watching TikTok and this woman said, if it was weird to say woman, a woman always feels so like she's 40 years old, but then girl sounds like she's 12. This lady sounds like she's 60. This woman, this person, that sounds better. This influencer? Anyway, reading into it too much. Anyway, she was talking about a product that she wants to gatekeep. And you know when someone wants to gatekeep something, it's good. So she said, everyone asks her what her foundation is, and it is this. And I actually saw this and thought, wait, I think I have one of those in my collection. But I only had like the lightest shade. So I went to the shop and bought light medium, which looks really dark still. So it is the CoverGirl Clean Fresh Skin Milk. That name freaks me out. Skin milk. Skin milk. 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 Kind of the same kind of vibe as moist. Not as bad. Milk. I think as the way you say milk reminds me of the taste that you get when you actually drink cow's milk, which I haven't done in God knows how long. Milk. That claggy milk. Maybe it's the morning and I'm still kind of waking up, but milk just sounds like skin milk, skin moist. Moist sounds better to me right now, moist. Okay, I need to stop. This is, light medium. Blurs imperfections, evens out skin tone, sheer buildable coverage, instant all day hydration, cruelty free. That's pretty damn cool, I think, of CoverGirl. That's right, I used this product in a sponsored video, I think. But it's been so long since I did that video that I can't even remember what it's like. It must have been good if I did the video on it. But the fact that they are like a drugstore brand but don't test on animals, I don't know what the situation is for other brands these days. That seems just like very cutting edge. I remember seeing that and being like, damn, that's cool. If only other brands like L'Oreal and stuff could follow suit. You right, Mies? You can get out of there, you know, you fit through that gap. She doesn't believe in herself. She doesn't think she can get through that gap. She can. She can. You can do it if you believe in yourself. Let's get this brush because I feel like it. The Tapered Complexion Brush by Mecca Max. Yeah, this is really dark for light medium. Ah! Whoa! This just came shooting out like a bazooka. Like projectile vomit. I wish I had that filmed. Whoa, I must have shaken it and then not let it go like this properly and for the and not let the product go back down into the tube. Well, that's a whole waste of makeup. Can I squeeze it back into the, and that's pretty very sanitary. Oh well, I got it on sale. It was $10 half price, so I really shouldn't be complaining about. No, I don't like wasting anything. I feel like that's just in my nature from growing up. Okay, good product, good color match. My battery's about to die, so I'm hoping I can at least get some applied before it dies. Ooh, my brush smells like, this is a new brush, so it shouldn't be the brush. It smells like barley, like rice. You know how barley has that kind of, I don't know, just that cooked delicious rice smell? Sometimes it's delicious, other times it's not. It smells like basmati rice. I don't know how to feel about that. Makes me a little bit hungry, a little bit concerned. Okay, so it looks beautiful. That looks gorgeous, doesn't it? So it's definitely not full coverage, which it didn't claim to be. What is she doing? Believe in yourself, you can do it. I don't know why she... Sometimes she'll come storming in after a W-A-L-K and she'll push doors open. She'll put a little pause on them and push them open. She's got a decent gap, but she's like, nah, guys, this is too much. You're asking too much. I don't know, guys. That looks pretty damn good. Even the finish. Sorry, I'm looking in the viewfinder. I bought an attachment for my DSLR so I can film with that. Even though I like filming with this, because I don't film with my DSLR anymore. It's so exciting buying tech stuff. Anyway, I'm not talking about tech stuff right now. Oh, my phone just... Sometimes I think I have the attention span of a goldfish. Not even. I won't even do goldfish like that. Okay, so in 3 days I did 24,500 steps. I've never reached my step goal and I don't know how that's possible. I do like 45 minute walks and then walk around a little bit and I still don't reach 10,000, but it's fine. Again, I'm still talking about tech. I need to stop. Okay. It looks pretty good though. Let me get up close so you can see. Nice. Mia is about to bark soon because a dog is about to walk past. I've got to say, I received a product from someone. I'm going to be super vague because I don't want this to come across as bitchy. I legitimately don't want anyone figuring out who I'm talking about, but I still want to mention it. I received a product from someone in PR. So I tried it out and the smell was so overwhelming. There were two things that smelled. One thing came with a package and that was somehow fragranced. And it wasn't like a consumable makeup product. It was like a tool type makeup product. And it smelled so strong that I had to immediately put it into the washing machine because it made my hands smell. It's all I could smell in my makeup room. And then the product itself had a fragrance and that was like kind of the selling point of the product. And it made me feel so sick. Like whoa, that was a really bad stutter. It made me feel so sick with a headache. Like it gave me such a headache and I could smell it on my hands and I kept saying to Reese, can you smell this? Can you smell this? It was so sickeningly sweet and it made something else that I used it with so sweet. And I love that kind of smell normally, but it was so intense. I don't know how people can use that without like a sensory overload. Although to be fair, I think I do have a really delicate sense of smell. Like I smell everything. Like Reese and I will just be doing anything and I'll just stop and go. And he's like, oh, what? And I've always been like this. Even when like mum would make me dinner, I'd be like, this smells weird. And she'd be like, yeah, well, good thing you're not smelling it, you're eating it. Or something along those lines. And even Mia knows when I'm sniffing. She's like, oh, did I do something wrong? I think I have a really keen sense of smell. So maybe that's why it really affected me in that way. I had to put it in a drawer and just, because like in theory I wanted to use the product because it's something that I do use, but it was just too much. I think any fragrance added to that product would have smelled too much. I think there was just too much fragrance added. I should just donate the product actually, or give it to, that's the thing, I don't think anyone, I don't know of anyone that, I don't know, anyway. I don't want this to come across as bitchy, even though hopefully you don't know who I'm talking about. Each to their own. The brand seems to be doing well, and that is the main thing. All products aren't going to work for all people. You know, some people hate Blanche Face Lash, and that's fine. I knew that going into it, that makeup or makeup accessories or tools or anything of that nature is very personal, and you're never going to, it's like some people hate me. You're never going to please everyone. So you shouldn't expect to, otherwise you're just going to be disappointed. So I'm sure, yeah, I'm sure they've received that feedback before. I'm sure they listened, and I'm sure they just, other people love it. So it's just one of those things where, yeah, you take it on board and you do with it what you will. But anyway, that was the Hourglass Vanish Concealer. And that looks quite lovely, if I do say so myself. But that concealer looks beautiful with everything, pretty much. I didn't really have a good first impression. I haven't really changed my mind on it either. The Fenty Pro Filter Foundations. I bought these myself and had high hopes, and they're fine. But when you're spending, you know, more money than you might on other products, I think I just have such high expectations of Fenty because their products are so good, and I just love everything else that they do, pretty much. What about everything? Some of the products aren't really up my alley, like they have a lot of cream products and stuff which I don't really use. But foundation, the hydrating foundation, is probably like my favorite foundation. Oh no, what am I doing? This is not light enough, but I've already done it, so now I've got to commit to it. This is the powder in 140. I just noticed it darkening my foundation, which is my ultimate fear. So, yeah, 140 Soft Matte Powder Foundation. I mean, damn, I'm really going in with the powder foundation over concealer and foundation already. Kind of defeats the purpose of using a nice dewy foundation, but, and I've been guilty of this before. I'm gonna point out something that I find funny that I'm also guilty of. So, I'm not like mocking anyone. If I'm mocking anyone, I'm mocking myself included. It makes me laugh now when I see using 240. People apply this beautiful glowy base, and they put all this effort into like mixing their foundation with a glowy illuminizer or whatever, and then they go over with powder. I genuinely don't think that there is any point then in adding, and then I've done this millions of times, I think you just want to think that it does something, but I really don't think it does. I don't know, because the illuminizer really only works when it has the ability to be like wet and shiny. Otherwise, wow, I'm not paying attention. I'm talking as I'm doing this, and I've just made my face a completely different color. Can you tell that in the screen? This must be, I think it's like more of a peachy tone. Oh well, again, I've come this far. It's fine. I'm not really doing anything important today. I just feel like putting on makeup, so it doesn't really matter what I do, but I'm completely covering up the foundation. But to be fair, all of it looks beautiful together. Like my skin itself looks really nice. But anyway, yeah, it always just makes me laugh because it is kind of pointless. I don't know. I mean, if you think that's not true, if you think it does do something, feel free to leave a comment. But at least in my own experience, I feel like it just defeats all of that hard work, which is a shame. Interesting. This powder foundation, considering I'm like pressing this into my skin, my face still feels kind of like tacky a bit. We will stick with Too Faced and use the Milk Chocolate Soleil Light / Medium Matte Bronzer. And just darken up the cheekbone, the ears a little bit, the forehead. Yeah, on Instagram, I posted looking for an eyelash serum to make my eyelashes grow longer. Because like, not longer, thicker. I feel like as I've gotten older, my lashes, the lash growth has slowed down. And, well, maybe it hasn't slowed down. It's just, I feel like my lashes aren't as thick. When I'm looking through old photos, I just had so many eyelashes. Like, whoa. And I'm not complaining about my eyelashes now because I still really am lucky to have long eyelashes, but they're just different. So I was like, okay, I'm gonna try an eyelash serum. I've heard good things about them. Hopefully my lashes will get nice and thick. It's the Hourglass Ambient Lighting Blush in Diffused Heat. Yeah, I didn't want length. My lash is already long and I find that too much length gets annoying. But I just wanted thickness. So I initially wanted Eye Envy because I had heard really good things about Eye Envy, but it's really difficult to find unless you frequent like a hair salon or a beauty salon or something. And where I live now, they don't have any, their website says they didn't have any stockists, so I just couldn't get it. I reached out to a few places, they don't sell it. I was like, okay, I guess I'll just give up on that. And then I heard of Lilash, and I saw an influencer that I follow post about her experiences, and her name's Kate Jones, Dedicated Lifestyle. Legend, I think you, yeah, shout out to Kate, follow her page. The amount of dedication she puts into her content, chef's kiss. Anyway, she has had an amazing experience with it. Her lashes are like, poof. So I instantly thought, okay, great, that's the one I'm going to try then. Next product, Bare Minerals Invisible Glow Powder Highlighter in Fair to Light. So I'm pretty sure you cannot buy it in, I'm not feeling that, but I'm gonna keep going. It's, again, my fault, Fair to Light. It's gonna have more of like a pinkish tinge, which it would need to if it's been applied to fair skin, but yeah, my product, not the product's fault. So yes, you can't buy it in Australia, it seems like. So it was actually really nice. So I had to buy it from New Zealand, and I bought it from the same place that she bought it. And so I started using it like every couple of days because I didn't want them to grow too intensely. And I thought that would be fine because the product, like the box says, once you've been using it for a long time and you've started to see results, you can pair it back and you don't need to use it as frequently because it has worked and you can give your lashes a break. So I thought, it should be fine then if I'm using it every second day. And then I wasn't really seeing anything happen. I don't know how long that was, a couple of weeks. So I was like, you know what, I'm just gonna use it every single day. And so I started using it every single day. All right, I'm trying a new eyebrow product that I can't tell you about. Hopefully you can't see it in the mirror. No, you can't. So that's why I'm not talking about the product, but I guess you can, it's good. It's good because before I couldn't even tell you that I can't tell you what the product I'm using, because then you'd know that I was starting a makeup brand. Whereas now that you know it's a makeup brand, you won't be surprised if I'm trying, like I can be more open about what, like why I'm not mentioning something. Anyway, okay. So I started using it every single day and my eyelashes started coming out, to put it bluntly. And it wasn't like me pulling on my eyelashes or anything like that. It was like, it's a certain feeling you get sometimes where your lashes need to come out. And when I was blinking, I could feel it. And I'm kind of obsessive with things like that. If I feel like an eyelash needs to go, I will encourage it to, I just can't help it. And it's a bad habit, but this was different. I wasn't pulling out eyelashes that weren't ready to come out. It was like I would touch my lashes like this, even just, not even to pull it out, even just to like, just to comb my lashes or something, and eyelashes would come out. And I was left with a couple of bare patches, and that was freaking me out. So I went to Instagram and I asked, is this a common thing? Has anyone else experienced it? Thinking that it would just be like a me thing. And a lot of people said, no, this is common, happened to me. And then someone linked me to a video about eyelash serums. And I watched the video from a dermatologist, and it was saying how like eyelash serums can like I knew that it could darken the lash line, like your actual skin, make it like more red, but I didn't know that it can also increase the development of blood vessels underneath your eyelashes and your, you know, dark circles, basically making you look like you have, actually giving you dark circles because of that increased amount of blood vessels. And it can also reduce the fat on your eyelids, so it can make your eyes appear more sunken, and yeah, it can encourage the loss of fat in some way on your eyelid, on your lash line. And I'd known that it can also darken your iris. I just assumed that was like a rare thing. But then I had people messaging me saying, yeah, that happened to me, yeah, that happened to me. And I was like, holy crap, maybe this is not worth it. I'm sure that maybe if I stuck to it, my lashes would all... The website says, no, it doesn't cause your eyelashes to fall out. Maybe they're just like... they're likely just sinking to the same growth cycle or something like that. And people were saying, yeah, it causes your lashes to fall out, and then new stronger ones grow back in, and all this stuff. I was seeing that it's like, no, it's not all that bad, but a lot of people said they had bad experiences with it, so I didn't want to lose more in the hopes that it will solve that problem that I was having. And also, once you use it, your body begins to rely on it, so I don't like that either. That I'd basically have to use it forever if I wanted my lashes to look like that. And if it causes those side effects, then I would just rather have a few less lashes. Look, I know, I'm sure my lashes could get amazing if I stuck to it, but, and it's funny because I also saw an influencer being sent Lilash by one of the distributors, and I thought, oh cool, I wonder what her experience will be. And I didn't follow up, I just forgot that she was even sent it. And she messaged me after seeing those stories and said that she had a massive reaction to using it. So I was like, damn, okay, yeah, let's just not go down that route and avoid it. So I have all mascara in, well, on my, I've noticed the lash loss on my lower lashes more so than my top lashes. Still on my top lashes, but not as much. So I haven't been wearing any mascara on my lower lashes, and I've been avoiding wearing it on my upper lashes too, just so they can kind of get healthier and stronger. I don't mean this as a plug for Lounge Face Lash or anything like that, but because of the way it removes, it just slides off so easily. It is the best product to use if I'm going to be wearing mascara, because it comes off so easily that I don't need to tug at my lashes to get it off. So I can still wear it, I'm just being particularly cautious. So that's not to say don't use it, it's just, if you're going to use it, proceed with caution. That stopped recording, I'm not sure where it stopped. I was just saying how I need to get my hair done again. And I look through old photos and I'm like, oh man, long hair. Ooh, so nice. And then I look through recent photos and I'm like, oh, short hair, looks much better. And it's just a seesaw, like back and forth. The thing that I like about having short hair is that it just looks more chic or something. It just looks cooler. It looks like, I don't know, more sophisticated or something. It just looks more mature, I guess. Not in like an old person way. Well, maybe for some people it looks like that, but for me, I don't get that feeling. But the thing that I like about long hair is the fact that I can style it. And I can do waves, and I can do wet waves in my hair now, but it doesn't have the same kind of beachy look. And I can curl it, not that I ever really did that anyway, because it dropped out so quickly. I can tie it up in a ponytail. I do miss that. That's one thing I don't like about short hair, is that I get all these little bits when I have my hair up, and there isn't really much I can do with it other than having it straight, which I do like, and having it wavy. And that's the thing, I think that's why I like the short hair, is because 9 times out of 10 I really don't do anything with my hair, and I can be optimistic and say, yeah, I'm gonna start styling my hair and putting more effort in, but realistically I'm not going to do that. So I feel like short hair looks better by default when it's straight, better than long hair did, because long hair, long straight hair just makes my face look longer and kind of drags it down, whereas short straight hair looks more stylish, I think, and is more flattering than the alternatives. So I think I'm still partial to short hair for the time being. So I'm really liking this product that I use on my brows. Pretty good match, I think. I think I applied too much at the beginning of my brow because it's darker than I would normally like it. I am going to try and use these two Urban Decay pencils to create a winged liner, which is very difficult to do, I think. Using pencils to do this is very difficult. So if I stuff it up, I will just turn it into a smudgy look. Whoops, I'm just going too fast. I'm just whacking on my eyeballs. This is in the shade Lucky. Hopefully I will be. I definitely did it too thick, but it's kind of hard to control. Ah! What am I doing? I'm already so over this. I'll give it to the pencils though. Really creamy. That is the thickest eyeliner I've done in a long time. Oh, I hate it. Let me use the Quick Fix Makeup Eraser Pen from the Quick Flick. It means I'm going to have to go over with foundation, but that is fine. I really thought I was doing something. Is this staining my lashes, or that's just the color of my eyelids underneath? Actually, I think I'm gonna switch to a Q-tip and same brand, Flick Off. It's micellar water. Oops. Oof. Whoa. Oh my god, that's my micellar water. It's gonna be taken off my foundation. No. Is someone upstairs like angry at me, or downstairs? Man, what's going on? Jesus Christ. That is the first time that's ever happened, and it had to happen on camera. I used a Huda Beauty neon eyeshadow palette the other day. Loved the color. It was like, you know, yeah, neon pink or something. But it stained my eyelids pink. I had pink eye or something. I'm probably really unintelligent for doing this, for trying winged liner again. I just don't feel like wearing eyeshadow for some reason, and I feel like wearing a wing. So let's try the Tartist. What is this? Brown Double Take Eyeliner. This side has a wind up crayon, and this side has a felt tip full stop, and it's brown. Don't know why I'm wearing brown today, just am. All right, wish me luck, please. Thoughts and prayers. So far so good. This little dingly thing is annoying though, because it moves every time I move my thing, and it distracts me. Like, cute, I guess, but not necessary on an eyeliner of all products. Thank you and good night. Okay. I'm editing this footage and the whole video. I didn't realize how like grumpy I sound. I don't think I was grumpy. I think it was just one of those days where everything that I ended up saying had a negative spin on it. Some days we have those days, okay? Yeah. And I had just woken up. But I just wanted to clarify, because everything that I'm saying is like a complaint of some sort, and people tend to notice that. So disclaimer,
This is just the way life works. Sorry.
This is why I don't like felt tip pens, because they pick up foundation really easily, reducing their efficacy. That's why I like the bristle nibs. This one isn't as crisp as this one. I think it's because this one has foundation on the tip now. Yeah, I don't know why they look so different. Can you see how that one's really crisp and this one is not? And now I'm gonna spend too long trying to fix it and I'm gonna make it worse. Whoops, and I already, yep, did that. Who do I think I am? Now the process of slowly making it thicker and thicker begins. No. I'm so severely over this now. This is just too much. Now I need a reminder to be mindful and to take a breath. I'm not even kidding you, I'm taking it off again. I'm not even playing games. Some days you just have to submit to the powers that be and say, yep, got it. Got it. It is, yep, no. This was never meant for me. And I will just slowly retreat, cower even, crawl back into my hole after a shocking defeat by eyeliner. Defeated, mercilessly defeated. She tried, but ultimately she was not strong enough. She goes home with her head lowered, eyes red and sore from being constantly wiped with micellar water. And she reflects on her time, on her experience that morning, and she thinks she was a fool. A fool for thinking things could be different. A fool for wanting a better life for her eyes. A fool for believing in herself. All right, I'm done. I will throw these into a fire. So I need you all to pretend like none of that happened. What even didn't happen? I don't know. Sorry if my mood seems very hard to please or very negative. I actually haven't had breakfast, so I'm probably quickly descending into being hungry and I don't even realize. I don't feel angry, I just feel defeated at this point in my life. Alright, I'm going to curl my lashes before applying a lash mascara. This is the first makeup tutorial that I'm actually able to share that I'm using my own brand. Love it. This isn't like, you don't need to curl your lashes. I never used to curl my lashes. But again, as the years have progressed, I find that it helps. Maybe they had more of a curl in them before. I don't know. I don't know. So I like to curl them and it does make them look longer. I think it's worth curling them, but I also kind of find eyelash curlers scary. I'm always terrified that one day they're just gonna chop all of my lashes off. So touch wood, shouldn't even joke about that. Well, I'm actually not joking, I'm scared of that, but. Okay, let's talk about Lounge Face Lash. I need to do proper posts on this. Oh, I've got to, look at that gap in my eyelashes. If my eyelashes look crap today, it's not because of the mascara, it's purely because of this damn, oh my God, even though they're growing. oops, my name has just come out. Okay, serious face on so it doesn't look like I'm talking to myself. Yes, I need to mention this on the Lounge Face Insta, and I've mentioned it on the website now, but this, and I did mention it in the video, actually the launch video, I did mention this, but I didn't mention this tip specifically. It's raining outside, so if you can hear sounds, that's what it is. This is not a wet formula. This mascara does not have a wet formula. So if you're used to having to wait between lash applications, layers, you do not have to do that with this mascara. So if you're trying to, see how I haven't stopped once? Normally with some mascaras, you stop, you wait for it to dry a little bit, and then you go in with another layer. This one does not need to be waited for. That was a terrible sentence. You do not need to wait. Just keep going, keep building forever and ever until you reach a point that you're happy with. But do not wait. Do not do one eye and then the other eye. Unless you're really confident in your abilities with mascara or something. I don't know what that even means. But I just keep going. I don't even, sometimes I'll do both eyes. Sometimes I'll work on them at the same time, but not often. Because if you do wait, and I also use, I need to stick to one topic at a time. If you do wait and then you go in and apply another layer, you are going to get clumpy lashes. They are going to look clumpy. I'm not even going to lie and say they won't, they will. Because the mascara is dried. And when you try and put more mascara on top of mascara that's already dried, it's just going to build up and get crumbly and clumpy and not look cute. So if you've got lounge face or you're thinking about trying lounge face, please do keep that in mind because it makes such a difference. And if you're super pedantic about your lashes like I am, but it doesn't matter what mascara I'm using, I always use an eyelash, tweezers to separate my lashes. Like, our wand is incredible at separating your lashes, which I'm really glad a lot of people have also picked up on and appreciate. It has spiky bristles, which do an incredible job of separating your lashes as you apply the mascara, which is really important to me because I like fanned out lashes. Everything is designed, this mascara is designed to make your lashes look like. So, I mean, I've got to clean out a little bit of mascara there, but keep in mind this is a bad eyelash day for me because I'm missing many of them and they're growing back in weird directions. So that is, I mean, actually that looks quite nice on the camera. Maybe it's not a bad eyelash day. But that's what happens when I stick to one application, no breaks, and use tweezers to separate any stubborn lashes. And I saw the All Bases podcast, I believe it's called. They did a 30 minute review on the mascara, which was really nice of them. And then I think, was it the Instagram stories that they did as well? But they said, don't fear the wand, which is such a good point because I know it is spikier than other brands you may be used to, but again, that is intentional. It is for the separation of the lashes. Like, that's just with a couple of coats and already. Sorry, camera just died. I had to finish off my mascara. Can't even remember what I was talking about. Oh, that's right, the wand. It is spikier than you may be used to, but as I just said, it's for the separation. Once you become more familiar with the wand, it becomes easier to apply the mascara because you know how close you can get to the roots of your lashes without poking your eyeball. You know, like, the different movements you have to make with the wand to coat your lashes. Like, I like to, I mean, again, I've seen so many people apply it in different ways. You just watch me kind of, I like to like wiggle it and then pull upwards, wiggle it then pull upwards. One of the girls from that podcast, she's kind of just, I messaged her and I said, like, you apply mascara so delicately. It's just, I want to use this as an example, but she goes like this, like, just kind of and blinks each time and applies it that way. Everyone has such a unique way of applying mascara, so you kind of just have to find a way that works for you. But as she said, don't fear the wand. I know it is a little spiky, but it's for your benefit. It's always for your benefit. And you've just got to get used to using it, I guess, because some brands have really, like, you know, wands like that. And so I understand that it's a bit of a learning curve, changing wands, but it's worth the learning curve. It's worth sticking it out. So I'm going to apply mascara to my lower lashes. I normally don't like to go in with a fresh dip because it's going to apply a lot of mascara to my lower lashes, which is fine when I have my normal amount of lashes, but when I don't, it might be too much. So wherefore art thou, lower lashes? Oof, this side is the worst side. There's like three there. Oh man. And it's the worst because they're not even like, they're not even strong lashes. They're like thin lashes. No. This is why, see how they're all different lengths? This is why I haven't been wearing mascara on my lower lashes, because I'm waiting for them to all grow out. So I've got some super long ones, which is fine, but it just means that I can't have an even... Oh, they're so uneven in length. Yeah, God, be careful if you use those lash serums. But then some people have amazing experiences. So you know what? It really does just depend on what your body is going to do with it once it is in there. The mascara did a pretty damn good job of working with what it had. There's also been a funny bit of feedback, which I didn't even realize myself, because I haven't used another brand's mascara in, or tubing mascara especially, in so long, because I've been using my own. So I haven't had anything to compare mine to for so long, and it wasn't until the first person that ever really tried it and gave me this feedback was my sister. And since then I have heard it from customers and from like influencers and stuff. It's really cool. Tubing mascaras can tend to make your lashes feel very hard and kind of crispy, but this formula keeps them feeling like normal eyelashes. It keeps them feel not like lashes without anything on them, obviously, but how your lashes would feel if you had a traditional mascara on. So still soft, still fluffy, not hard or crispy, which is really cool. I didn't even notice because, yeah, I haven't had anything to compare it to in so long. So there's a little tidbit for you. And I hang a lip liner. This is the Urban Decay Naked 2 lip liner. For the middle color, I'm going to use the Morphe lipstick in Flirt. The bin man's coming by, so that's what you can hear. I just like to tap it on, because if you apply it, like if you wipe it on, it's just way too light. And now I'm going to mess all of this up and eat breakfast. What's the time? 10:09. That took about 2 hours. A little under 2 hours. About 20 minutes. Oh, and my battery is flashing. It's time to go, guys. Oh, that was a good stretch. Okay. Alright, team. Thanks for watching. Thanks for joining. Thanks for tuning in. Three ways of saying the same thing. I hope you have an amazing day. Thank you again. You can check out all the links to all the products in the description. You can follow Lounge Face on Instagram, Loz Curtis on Instagram, aka me, or my new house build Instagram, which is Loz Curtis Home. Stuff is actually happening. Our block is being developed. The land has been prepped for the sand, for the cement slab. It is happening. All right. Anyway, thanks for watching. I love you guys, and I hope to see you all in my next video. Bye!